Welcome to Bharathvansh YouTube channel. Please do like, comment, share and subscribe. Don't forget to press the bell icon for more updates.
The decline of the Indo-Scythian Empire started by the invasion of Parthians and Kushans in the north and northwestern part of India. Though the Sakas' rule ended in North India, they continued to rule as subordinates or Kshatrapas of Kushans for some time. Two families of Sakas declared independence and established new Saka kingdoms known as Western Kshatrapas. Western Satraps. They were the last set of Sakas who ruled the western part of India during 35 CE to 395 CE. They were contemporaries of Satavahanas, Kushans and Guptas. The official language of Sakas was Khatonese or Kharoshti as it is called in their language. Kshaharata family, capital Nasik, 80 CE to 124 CE. According to legends, three kings ruled as Kshatrapas of Kushans before the actual dynasty was founded. The three rulers were Epirajaya, Hospesus and Higaraka. The first two recorded rulers of this family under Kushans were Abhiraka, 80 CE to 100 CE, Bhumaka, 100 CE to 110 CE. Nahapana, 110 CE to 124 CE. He was the son of Bhumaka and one of the most important rulers of Western Kshatrapas. He became independent from Kushan suzerainty. He conquered many territories which extended from the coast of Bharuch up to Pakistan. He is mentioned as a great donor in inscriptions of numerous Buddhist caves at Nasik, as he had dedicated Chaitya and Viharas. The Chaitya complex of Karla Caves, the largest in South Asia, was constructed and dedicated in 120 CE by Nahapana. In 1938, a statue of goddess popular as Pompeii Lakshmi was discovered at the ruins of Pompeii in Italy. It is believed that the statue found its way to Pompeii during the reign of Nahapana. The statue was shipped to Roman Empire from the port of Barigaza or Bharuch, which was the result of the Indo-Rome trade relations. Nahapana married off his daughter Dakshamitra to Ushavadatta, who was a son of Dinika, commander of the army. Ushavadatta is also known as Rishabhadatta, was a practitioner of Brahminism and had accomplished various charities. He had donated 16 villages and 3 lakh cows to the Brahmins, and also he fed thousands of Brahmins every year on a particular day. He had donated 4 roomed rest houses in Bharuch, Mandsaur, Govardhan near Nasik and Shurparaka near Nalsopara. During the later years, he was influenced by his wife and attracted towards Buddhism, by which he donated some caves to Buddhists at Tirasmi Hill at Govardhan near Nasik. Rishabhadatta served Nahapana in many campaigns as military commander of Satrap army. He accompanied his father-in-law in the successful Satavahana campaign, which forced the Satavahana king to shift the capital. In 124 CE, Nahapana was killed with his son-in-law Rishabhadatta by Satavahana king Gautamiputra Satakarni. The family of Kshaharata was uprooted by the Satavahana ruler. Kardamaka or Bhadramuka family, capital Ujjain, 78 CE to 395 CE. Ghasmotika was of Scythian origin and ruled as the Kshatrapa of Sindh under Kushan. During his reign, his son Chastana, a young prince, established a new independent ruling family of Sakas named Kardamaka. Chastana or Chetas, 78 to 130 CE. He was the son of Ghasmotika and ruled as a Kshatrapa or subordinate to Kushan ruler in his initial reign. He founded the Kardamaka family and declared independence from the Kushan suzerainty. He defeated the last king of Gardabila dynasty, occupied Ujjain and established an era in memory of the event in 78 CE. The Shaka era started by him, later renamed as Shalivana Shaka in 11th century and used till today as a traditional calendar by South Indians, as similar to Vikramaera used in North India. The Sakas' invasion of Ujjain and establishment of the Shaka era marked the beginning of the long-lived Western Kshatrapa kingdom. Jayadaman, 130 CE. He was the son of Chastana. His reign as a king was very short, as he was killed by Satavahanas during a war. Rudradaman 1, 130 to 165 CE. He was the son of Jayadaman and served in the administration during his grandfather's reign. He is considered as the greatest ruler of the dynasty. He was a contemporary of Vasishthiputra Pulumavi and Vasishthiputra Satakarni brothers. Rudradaman married a Hindu woman and adopted Hindu and Indian modes of living. He was a good administrator and known for his liberality. Although he was a Scythian, he patronized Hindu culture. The records of his charities mention cows and Brahmins and not the monks and monasteries. He was perhaps a greater admirer of Hindu culture than his contemporary Satavahanas. He used Sanskrit and Satavahanas preferred Prakrit for official records. He was well educated in various sciences like grammar, polity, music, logic and war science. He was the first king to insert the longest inscription in Sanskrit. The Sanskrit inscription at Junagadh, Gujarat mentions the details about the repair work of Sudarshana Lake. The lake was constructed during the reign of Chandragupta Maurya and canals were drawn from the lake during the reign of Samrat Ashoka. His Andau inscription of Khavda in Kutch gives the details of genealogy of his ancestors. During his reign, Greek writer Yavaneshwara translated Yavana Jataka from Greek to Sanskrit, which influenced astrology in India. He issued silver coins which mentioned his name as Mahakshatrapa, as he won the title himself. Rudradaman was a contemporary of Vasishthiputra Pulumavi and defeated him twice. He defeated Satavahanas and regained territories previously lost to Gautamiputra Satakarni by Nahapana. In an indecisive war, he offered his daughter Rudradamanika in marriage to Vasishthiputra Satakarni, the younger brother of Pulumavi. The clash between the two dynasties halted for some time because of this matrimonial relationship. Rudradaman defeated Yodhayas and conquered present-day Haryana region. He was attacked by Nagas, who were aggressive towards Shaka Empire. The extension of dominion by Nagas was put on hold during his reign. Rudradaman's successors didn't have any eventful reign and ruled peacefully. During the reign of Rudrasimha I, in 188 CE, the Abhira leader Ishwaradatta occupied the throne and declared himself as Mahakshatrapa. The king was made Kshatrapa or subordinate king during this period. During this period, the Satavahana ruler Yajnasri Satakarni took advantage and annexed many territories to his dominion. Within 3 years, Rudrasimha I managed to consolidate his loyalists and regained the throne from usurper. Ishwaradatta, 236 to 239 CE. He reoccupied the throne in 236 CE. He allowed Damajadasri to rule as his subordinate. He was killed by Yashodhaman I and Sakas regained the kingdom from the usurper. Rudrasena II, 255 to 277 CE. He brought back the glory and revived the greatness of the dynasty. He regained lost territories of Sanchi, Vidisha from the Nagas, which was previously conquered during the time of Satavahanas. His daughter Rudradhara Bhattarika was married to Virapurushadatta, the king of Andhra Ikshvaku dynasty, the successor dynasty of Satavahanas. He had two sons, Vishwasimha and Bharatadaman, who ruled one after the other. Yashodhaman II, 317 to 332 CE. He was the eldest son of Rudrasimha II. During his reign, there were threats from the newly established Vakataka dynasty. King Pravarasena I defeated him many times, which shrunk Shaka dominion. Interregnum period, 332 CE to 342 CE. Between 332 to 342 CE, the kingdom was under anarchy. The kingdom was occupied by Sassanids and Vakatakas and was ruled by them in succession during this period. Swami Rudradaman II, 342-348 CE. He was second son of Rudrasimha II and regained the capital from the enemies. He used Swami before his name, which was followed by his successors. He is considered as the fourth founder of the Kardamaka ruling family. Swami Rudrasena III, 348-380 CE. He was son of Rudradaman II. He was the longest reigned ruler of the dynasty. His term of more than 30 years was full of ups and downs. In 356 CE, he was very badly defeated by the Sasanid king, which ruined the prestige of Shaka dynasty and emptied the treasury. Ultimately, he was defeated and subjugated by the great ruler Samudragupta. He was continually defeated by Vakatakas, Sasanids and Kadambas between 356 CE to 360 CE. Rudrasena III was able to reassert his lost capital and regain the throne from Kadambas after the death of Mayura Varma, the founder of Kadamba dynasty. He was succeeded by his sister's son as his children died before him. Swami Simhasena, 380-384 CE. Swami Rudrasena IV, 384-388 CE. Swami Rudrasimha III, 388-395 CE. He was the son of Satyasena, brother of Simhasena. He captured the throne from his cousin Rudrasena IV. The Shaka kingdom was under close watch during his reign by the Gupta king Chandragupta II. The Guptas were already near in the northern neighborhood. In the south and east, it was the Vakataka kingdom whose king was Rudrasena II and was married to Chandragupta II's daughter Prabhavati Gupta. The Kadambas of Banavasi, who were south of Satrap kingdom, also had matrimonial relationship with Guptas, as the daughter of Kakutsa Varma was married to Kumaragupta, the son of Chandragupta II. Chandragupta was eager to annex westernmost part of India to his empire, and he planned an attack with the combined Gupta, Vakataka and Kadamba armies. The plan could not be initiated due to the sudden death of Vakataka king and the defeat of Kadamba ruler in the south region. In 395 CE, after consolidating his army, Chandragupta II invaded Kshatrapa kingdom with the Vakataka army and defeated Rudrasimha III. The Shaka king was killed in the battle. Chandragupta was titled as Vikramaditya, as he was the second king to vanquish Shakas from the map, first being Vikramaditya of Gadabhila dynasty. Chandragupta was also called as Shakari, as he ended the Shaka dynasty. The Gupta empire extended from east to west of India. This event completely ended the 4-centuries-long rule of Shakas on the Indian subcontinent. Hope you liked this video. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to Bharatvansh channel. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get more updates.